All students, today in this video we will be covering the chapter Resources and Development. Here are the content of this chapter. Firstly, we will discuss about introduction of resources, then classification of resources, agenda 21, land resources, land degradation, and at last we will discuss about soil. So let's start our topic with introduction of resources. What is resources? Anything in our environment that can be used to satisfy our need is called resources. It can be living or non-living. For example, this is also a resource for us because it fulfills our need of writing. Let us understand this topic with some more examples.
A resource is anything we need or use. Look around you. Anything you can pick out is a resource. For example, smartphone is a resource because you can use it to call your friends, check weather forecast, play games, and for study.
Resources should be economically feasible, culturally acceptable, and technologically accessible. First, we have economically feasible. Economically feasible here means that you should not spend too much money. For example, in order to give electricity to a large building, we should not use solar energy because it is expensive resources to be used. Next, we have culturally acceptable. For that, an example will be tiger skin or wildlife. It would be resource for some individual, but it won't be culturally acceptable in our country. Third, we have technologically accessible. For using the water to conduct electricity, we need dams, generator, etc. Without this, water can never be resources. So, technology is also our important fact. In short, we can say that these are the three important criteria for resource to be called resources. Next, we have characteristics of resources. The resources comes from our physical environment. Human beings are at the center of the one component called biosphere. As you can see the examples on the clip.
Economic. Human beings make resources available through the economic activities. Social. Human institution, industries and society accelerate the development. Technology. It is the main human agenda of transformation of materials available in nature into resources.
Let's talk about classification of resources. Resources are classified into four parts. First is on the basis of origin. Second is on the basis of exhaustibility. Third is on the basis of ownership. And the last is on the basis of status of development. Let's talk about on the basis of origin. On the basis of origin, resources are classified into two parts, biotic and abiotic.
Wow! This pond has lots of species as well as lots of plants too.
To understand any ecosystem, we need to understand biotic and abiotic factors of that ecosystem first.
I know. Biotic factors are all of the living organisms within an ecosystem, like in this pond. Biotic factors are these plants and animals.
Yes, you are right. Now tell me the definition of abiotic factors.
Abiotic factors are all of the non-living things in an ecosystem. For pond ecosystem, few of the abiotic factors are water, sun, soil under the pond, dissolved oxygen in the water, etc., etc.
Very good. And let me tell you, abiotic and biotic factors are related with each other. Abiotic factors are very important for an ecosystem. If one factor is removed, it will affect all the biotic factors.
You are correct. If water is removed from the pond, there would not be any fish, tortoise or swan.
You are a genius.
That's a very good example. And if the water in the pond dries, many of these aquatic plants will also die. Oh yeah.
This is all about today's class. In next video, we will discuss about Agenda 21. Thank you.